Welcome back to Proactive. I'm delighted to be joined on the line now by Terry Pullen, who is the CEO and acting chairman of GreenBank Capital. A very warm welcome to you, Terry. Thank you very much for taking the time to come and talk to us today at Proactive. Some big news out yesterday. You're conducting a strategic review. Perhaps you'd like to start by just giving us a quick summary of it.
Yes, certainly. Thank you, Tom. The key thing is that with our review, we feel that the platform that we've got at GreenBank is nimble and versatile enough to be able to really reflect back on the last year. That's been a very difficult year in global markets for the obvious reasons to do with the turmoil due to war and cost price inflation and lots of sort of political sort of risk across the whole world and the doubt that creates. Clearly, our responsibility is to face these things head on, and very much myself and the team that we have is responsibility is to make sure that we deliver something that shareholders have got to actually believe in is going to be delivered. And frankly, that over the last year, if you look at our share price, that isn't great reading. Whilst it's been aligned to the CSE and many small markets as a whole, we feel we can't sit there and watch it. We've got to do something about it. And the review is to take stock, work out what we've got, what we're going to do with it, and how we're going to impact that for the benefit of our shareholders and potential new investors alike.
And it's a great moment to take stock, isn't it? Because you've recently brought on board Bob Neil MP.
That's correct. Yeah. So Bob Neil is obviously a preeminent person in British politics, acting as the chairman of the Justice Committee for the UK government as we speak, along with representing his constituents in the area that he's a member for Parliament. Bob is a very direct person, a very good communicator, and he's acted as a fantastic foil in a very short space of time within this review to be very objective in terms of, okay, this is where GreenBank is, this is where it's come from, this is what you and the existing team, Terry, inherited. What is it that you're going to do to introduce confidence, value, and shareholder belief that your strategy is worth following? It's quite important with an entrepreneurial attitude to have those questions effectively posed and objectively questioned in terms of the way our business direction is going forward.
Understood, Terry. So you are obviously the man in the big chair. So what do you think will be the outcome of this review?
Yeah, certainly. I think the outcome, and we hinted to it in a press release that we put out yesterday. I think it's back to basics. And the back to basics is that what we want to do is we want to assess what we've got and how quickly those investments that we have are going to come to income. And some of those that are in income, when is that income going to enable us to be represented in terms of a company value, and that company value that accurately reflects our share price? And my view is, in today's world, what we have to do is we have to be reliant on more tangible elements. And the great news about that is that's something that I certainly, and with the team that we've got, in Steve, and Bob and Richard, we've got some really good experience there, whereby we can talk openly, honestly, directly about actually what we've got, and not rely on, any smoke and mirrors attitude. We can really look at the tangible benefits that we've got, and that will naturally reflect into EBITDA and profit and loss and, those good old-fashioned sort of metrics that justify a real value that will give shareholders the absolute belief in what they're invested in and what they have invested in. And that gives, hopefully, them confidence that, we're a team to support going into the future and to give them what they want, which is, a great share price and a stock that's one to watch that other people want to support and invest in.
So, Terry, I've just got one final question for you. What is it that you see in this business that you believe that others have probably been less willing to see over the last 12 months?
Possibly some of the things that we see with our boots on the ground is we've got a fantastic shareholder base. We really have got a great shareholder base. Those people, you know, we try and keep in contact with as best as we can, you know, whenever we can, with information that is able to be shared. With the shareholder base, with the talent that we've got in terms of experience in the table at the table at the moment, and with the opportunities that we find, the opportunities that we've got in the existing investments, along with opportunities that regularly come our way, I believe we've got an opportunity to truly be incredibly different to and incredibly modern in the way that we build businesses, scale them, and actually achieve a value that's real, a value that's easily identified, and then therefore a value that will lead to, you know, a fantastic investment for people that want to have confidence in the way we want to lead this forward. We also have, I believe, you know, a credible open door policy that means if you want to talk to us, if you want to know the ins and outs of what we're doing, come and talk to us. We're here in London, we're on Zoom, we're on the phone, and that open door policy gives us the transparency that I believe will lead GreenBank Capital to being a fantastic stock for the future.
Crystal clear. Thank you very much for your time this afternoon, Terry, and best of luck.
Thank you very much, Tom. Take care.